Witajcie, nazywam się Beata Kenik i niedawno miałam ogromną przyjemność i ogromny przywilej przetłumaczenia na język polski tej oto książki. To biografia wybitnej amerykańskiej astronomki Wery Rubin, a zarazem znakomity przegląd kilku dekad wielkich dokonań w dziedzinie astronomii i astrofizyki. A dzisiaj są ze mną autorzy tej książki, Jacqueline Mitten i Simon Mitten. Hello, thank you so much for joining me today.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello from Cambridge.
Simon and Jacqueline, I am so glad to be talking to you today. Because the Polish version of the book, Vera Rubin, A Life, will appear in Poland very, very soon, in August, and it will be published by the PWN Scientific Publishing House. And so if you could characterize, describe the book in a few words, make a short introduction. I know it's not easy, but what would you say?
Well, first of all, can we say how delighted we are that you've translated it? That's marvellous. As to what's the book about? Well, it's all about the person of Vera Rubin, the kind of person she was very much, as well as the scientific work that she did, because she was truly a remarkable woman, as well as a remarkable astronomer. And as well as achieving so much in her professional life, she also campaigned a great deal for the rights of women in astronomy and in science generally to be treated equally with men. And at the time when she was working, that certainly wasn't the case. So the book really covers her life partly in a chronological way, and partly in a thematic way. So I, for instance, picked up very much on the theme of her work for promoting women. Simon was very much involved in dealing with her academic papers. This was a bit of the way we split it. And I think that readers will enjoy both discovering her as a person, as well as learning something about an important part of 20th century astrophysics, which was all to do with dark matter and galaxies and so on.
And what was the most surprising or perhaps fascinating thing you discovered in the process of gathering the material and writing the book?
I knew Vera for 30 years. I knew her well, and I knew the field in which she was working. The really thrilling aspect about doing this work is that we were the first people to be given access to Vera's papers in the Library of Congress. So therefore, we were able to see in her own words, as it were, what was motivating her. Her most important research was on the nature of galaxies. She spent a lot of time observing them, and she came to the conclusion that galaxies were surrounded by large amounts of invisible dark matter. And she was the first to get the data that suggested this is what was going on. And of course, although she wasn't taken seriously at first, this did eventually become mainstream and made her world famous.
Yes, Vera's scientifically, she's almost synonymous with people beginning to understand dark matter in the universe. She wasn't the only one who did that, but very importantly, she persuaded a lot of people who were skeptical because her observations were really, really, really good and believable. And so that was really what was very important. And she absorbed lots and lots of galaxies, didn't she?
She did, yes. Mm-hmm. And from her papers, you can see over a period of many years, she was constantly challenging authorities who were consciously or unconsciously discriminating against women and making life difficult for her. And the little stories about that in the book are really interesting.
She had a very good sense of humour. She was stubborn, and she had this kind of ironic sense of humour, and she just never kept giving up on her campaigning, and she wrote these very kind of cutting letters and so on. So it's an interesting read, you know, even I think for someone who's not deeply into the scientific side, they'll get a great deal out of it just because she's such an interesting person. Okay,
Jacqueline and Simon, thank you so much for joining me today and for talking about this fascinating book and this fascinating person, Vera Rubin. Książka Vera Rubin, Życie, jej polska wersja, ukaże się w naszym kraju już bardzo, bardzo niedługo, bo w sierpniu, nakładem wydawnictwa naukowego PWN. No i serdecznie zapraszam do czytania.